Are new worries about the Taliban after a deadly attack by militants on a major hotel in Kabul. CBS News correspondent Mandy Clark is in Afghanistan this morning with the very latest. Mandy, good morning.
Good morning. Well, forensic teams are sweeping the hotel, searching for evidence and any more casualties from the Taliban assault that left at least 10 people dead.
The attack began late last night with an explosion at the first checkpoint leading to the hotel. Then gunmen, armed with rocket-propelled grenades and assault rifles, entered the building, spraying bullets in the lobby. Eyewitnesses say some of the militants were wearing suicide vests. The attack lasted until the early hours of this morning and only ended when a coalition helicopter opened fire, killing at least two insurgents on the rooftop. This morning, stunned survivors were still leaving.
This hotel is isolated, set up a hill. It's considered one of the safest locations in Kabul. Last night, it was playing host to a number of regional officials who were in the capital for government meetings. This attack seems to be a message from the Taliban that they can strike at any time.
17-year-old Ahmed Tamim was at the hotel when the assault began.
Did you see any of the attackers?
He says they were wearing police uniforms and they were firing at everyone. I ran out the back door. Despite the brazen attack, today's government meeting went ahead as scheduled. The subject under discussion, security, as foreign troops hand over territory to Afghan forces.
The identities of the dead are still unknown. At first, we were told that the victims were all Afghan civilians and two police officers, but now the Interior Minister says at least one Spanish man is among the dead. Erica.
Mandy Clark in Kabul this morning. Mandy, thanks.